We were very much impacted by COVID, especially in Europe in the first half of the year. But we were able, and thanks to the hard work of the teams, to really have a very good result on the second semester, growing the business, developing new ventures, being better in terms of performance and reducing our costs. Also, cash generation is a very good point, and we have been able to generate a lot of cash, working better our working capital, and all of that creates, of course, value for our shareholders. And this framework, first of all, we are able to confirm our 65 cents a share dividend in 2021 based on 2020 result, an exceptional distribution of 1 billion euro. And of course, this is giving us confidence to have 2021 slightly improved compared to the numbers and figures we announced earlier.
Now, I want to turn to one of the other big stories that we were just referencing, and that is the news overnight that the board of Suez, has unanimously rejected Veolia's offer for a takeover. Should we assume that the door is firmly closed now, or would the board reconsider if Veolia came back with a higher offer and more valuable economics?
I think that what we wanted to transmit and what the board wanted to transmit today is that on one side you have Suez with our strategic plan, Suez 2030. The results are there. We are creating value. We are able to improve our earning per shares, our cash flow generation. And I would say this is what today the 70% remaining shareholder of Suez have in hand. You have on the other hand this offer of Veolia. At last, we have an offer, something that we have been expecting for months. And it has a lot of flaws that were outlined by the board. First of all, in terms of value. And the second point is also, as part of the duty of the board, it's also to look at the impact on our teams, I mean, social impact, and also on our clients. I mean, we have long-term commitments, very essential services, and of course, our clients must not be the one paying for this operation. So we have those two positions, and the board can indicate it that it was open to dialogue and negotiation with Veolia to find maybe a landing point. And we hope to see that developing in the coming days and weeks.
And just to round out the discussion around what the issue is with the Veolia offer, yesterday when we spoke to the Veolia COO, I asked her to address union concerns, in particular around job security. And she stuck by the point that they are not looking to cut jobs, using the example that you can't use people to collect waste bins in Birmingham if they live in Scotland. Is that the problem here? Is that the holdup around your trust that jobs will be retained?
I think this is one of the few aspects, and but very important aspects of where the offer stands now. I mean, basically, because of antitrust regulation, Veolia cannot keep all the businesses. They will have to sell a large portion of the businesses in various geographies, and therefore, the people working for Suez are not sure where they are going to end up. Just to give you an example, in France, we have 30,000 employees. 20,000 of them, because of antitrust regulation, will have to leave Veolia if Veolia prevail in its offer. So they don't know where they are going to land. And how do you want to take social commitments if you don't know who will be the next employer? And then second point, when you merge two large corporations like those one, you know that there are duplication everywhere, research centers, support functions, and so on. And we estimate that the overall impact would be between 4,000 and 5,000 employees. So it's not to say that there is no issue. There are issues, but let's address them professionally when we look at this offer. And this is what we intend to do if the dialogue opens.